Hey, welcome back to the Zep Pearl channel. It's me, VK, your host, for another edition in my series. The first one, the one you never forget. It's a series where I talk about those first albums I got from a particular band or artist. Ones that you might bought a certain album and started with them and never got anything afterwards, and that's the only record you have from them. Or you bought something from them and boom, man, they just became your favorite band and you had to go out and get everything else, right? But that starting point, man, that album that you just fell in love with and said, man, I love this band and I need to get more. And it's that first one, that one you never can forget. So I'm going to do, obviously you can't tell already, if you can't tell already, the Rolling Stones. This is my Stones collection, my section here. Going from 12 by 5 to, what would they call this? It was a live album from Steel Wheels, 89-90 tours. Three album set, came out a couple years ago. There was an orange copy, I didn't get the orange, it's a black version. Black vinyl. And then, there's a lot of holes missing in between here, especially on the early albums. I don't have a lot of those because I like to find the, an original pressing or earlier pressings, whether it be 60s or 70s. I don't go out and pick up reissues a lot. Nothing against them because I do have some, but I like to try to get some of the older ones. What do I got? Beggar's Banquet, Exile, Goathead, Tattoo You, Some Girls, Emotional Rescue, Steel Wheels, and the classic, Dirty Work? With all that being said, which one was the first one that I got? Which is the one that I just never forgot, right? Well, it's and I've talked about this before. I was raised on radio, said it 1,000 times. I was a kid in the 70s listening to stations like WLS-AM here, which was the top 40 station of music radio 89, the big 89. Later discovering FM side and stations like, The Loop, WLUP here in Chicago, FM 98. And then later, Wii FM, there was a short-lived station. And then WMET, which is a big station, in the early, from late 70s, early 80s. Then it progressed, stations flipped and came and, after that, but those were the two main ones, man. It was The Loop and WMET that I would listen to a lot, and I would get my musical education from. I didn't have older brothers or sisters or even cousins that got me into music. The nearest thing was my uncle, and I would go over to visit my grandparents and my uncle, and he had all these 8-tracks, and I would just read the names. And he had like Black Sabbath 8-tracks, Led Zeppelin 8-tracks, Grand Funk Railroad 8-tracks. And I would see the names and Rolling Stones. He was a big Stones fan. So I would see all his 8-tracks that he had, at the time. And I would spin a thing and just read the names. They registered, and when I started going out buying records or getting them as gifts for Christmas and birthday and stuff, obviously that, when you're younger, that's what you're doing. Not until I started flipping pizzas. Then I go out and buy my own. The Rolling Stones were a staple in radio, classic rock radio. So yeah, I heard the songs there. Songs like Satisfaction, Get Off My Cloud, Brown Sugar, Simply with the Devil. You would hear all these songs on the radio and, Rolling Stones. I remember, I want to say, the first time that I saw the Rolling Stones like perform kind of thing was on Saturday Night Live. They played on Saturday Night Live. I want to say it was around the Some Girls era, so I'm thinking 78. I'm sure somebody will correct me in the comments. So that was the first kind of like seeing them on TV kind of thing. And it was all I remember, like, was it Mick like licking Keith's face or the other way around? It was a weird thing. What was I, like 11 or 12 or something like that? I was like, what is that? That's weird. But that was the Stones in the 70s, right? Just the flamboyant. I'm going off on tangents here. But the first album, what do I get? Well, the other part of the history is the first time I would see the Rolling Stones is 1981. I did a whole album on that, or a video on that called The Album and the Concert Series. So I did that on the Stones when I saw them here in Chicago. Blocking my face. I this is a little laminate, WMET, a station I was just talking about, sponsored it. And they were giving out these little, like, it's like a sticker, but like a backstage pass sticker. So I talk about this in that video. So check it out. The Album and the Concerts, Rolling Stones, 1981. I'll leave a link there or whatever. And also, I got to give a shout out to Patrick, the vinyl at the Vinyl Archivist channel. We're doing a throwdown over there. So look for that on his channel, where he's going to have a bunch of people on the panel. And we're all going to pick out our 10 favorite, or what we think are the best Rolling Stones, or however you want to do it. So everybody's gonna have their individual list of 10, and then we got to dwindle that, throw down, and argue what is gonna be the top 10 songs out of everybody's list and everything in there for the Rolling Stones song. So go down in the description box again, click on the Vinyl Archivist channel, and look for that video out there. It'll be a good time, and join us on the live streams over at Patrick's channel, The Vinyl Archivist, on Sunday, Tuesdays, and Fridays. It's always a good time. Friday's a free-for-all, so everybody can join in, so definitely jump in on the entertainment and fun and discussion, and you never know what's going to happen over there. It can get heated, it can get crazy, or just plain silly, and I like being silly. All right, so... Man, I'm really dragging this out for not a big ending. So my first Rolling Stones album, like I said, man, I was growing up on radio, I'd hear all the hits. So of course, what I call the greatest hits curse. The first album I got, Hot Rocks, 1964-71. My starting point for the Rolling Stones. This is the first album I ever picked up by them. And not a bad one, but, you know, there's that curse where I pick up a greatest hits and next thing you know, okay, I love every song. I want more. And then I go out and start doubling up and buying the full albums and things like that. So, luckily I didn't give this one away, because sometimes I did once I started, said, okay, well, I have all these songs, I'd give them away to either my sister or somebody that, you know, was getting into something. But this one I still have, and yeah, just song for song, man. There's great songs on this. It's not a bad starting point, especially if you're a casual fan. I mean, really casual, like, I don't like the Stones, I like what I hear on the radio kind of thing. It's a good place to start. But yeah, you got the Stones on the back, you got Charlie with a serious look there. And yeah, I mean, just the selections on here are just all top songs. Time on My Side, Heart of Stone, featuring Mr. Jimmy Page is a session player on this on guitar. Yep, it all circles back, my friends, I'm telling you. Mother's Little Helper, Making Nervous Breakout, Painted Black, Ruby Tuesday, Street Fighting Man, Brown Sugar, Midnight, a live version of Midnight Rambler, which is killer. So yeah, I got sucked into this and totally became, you know, it was all in the Stones, I wanted to get more. And then again, like 81, like I said, man, I went to go see them in concert. So I probably picked this up before that. So I want to say maybe like 1980, 81, I might have got this about 10 years after it was released. I think this came out December of 71. So about 10 years later, I finally get a Stones album. And that was around the time, like I said, I was buying records, you know. At 80, 81, I think I had like one of my first jobs. I was working at a pizza place, you know, as the bus boy. And then I finally got promoted and started making pizzas. So, you know, that's kind of had my own money. But prior to that, a lot of my records were like, you know, birthday gifts or Christmas, things like that. But yeah, man, Stones, first album. And again, here, you know, that age-old question, you know, people sometimes ask, are you a Stones guy or are you a Beatles guy? Beatles or Stones? Stones or Beatles, right? And for years, I would answer probably Beatles. But probably within the last 10, 15 years, I've kind of leaned towards more of the Rolling Stones as I got older and kind of, you know, just, you know, dig that, the rawness rock and roll kind of sound to it, the blues-based stuff. So I kind of lean towards more of the Stones now. Nothing against the Beatles. I think I got a bigger section of Beatles records. So there you go. But yeah, man, this was the first Stones album. The one I can't forget. I still have this, didn't get rid of it. And, you know, listening to it again, I mean, all the sequence of the songs is great. So yeah, this is solid record. So let me know in the comments below, what was your first Rolling Stones record? Did you ever go see them in concert? I would see them again in 1989, on the Steel Wheels tour. That's the only two times I've seen them, 81 and 89. That video will come out in the future whenever I get to 1989 on my album in the concert series. But yeah, let me know, what was your first Rolling Stones record? Love them or hate them? Are you a Beatles or Stones guy? You know, do you ever see them in concert or anything like that? Just put that in the comments below. So that's it, man. First one, the one you never forget, Rolling Stones, Hot Rocks, 1964 to 71. Thanks for tuning in, everybody, to the Zep Pearl channel. And we'll see you again. Later.